Hey everybody, it's Polar, it's nothing but more Banjo-Kazooie. In the last episode, we did Freeze Easy Peak. In this episode, we're gonna do more! Sometimes I wonder why I even bother with those. In the last episode, they did this. In this episode, we're gonna do this, because you know what we're gonna do. Like, jeez, man, you probably know by the title of the video, or even the thumbnail, you know? It's not a mystery what we're gonna do in this episode, unless I just end up doing nothing but, like, Gruntilda's lair stuff. Then it might be a mystery. But even then, it's like, well, is that really a mystery? Well, maybe it is. Are there any new faces? I'm still on the lookout for new faces. You bet your ass. You bet your ass. Dude, what the hell, man? You dumbass. Trying to dodge the monster, you walk right back off the ledge. Yeah. I will admit this trek might be getting a little bit old, but, well, I don't care, so... Yeah, that's about all there is to say on the matter. Hip. Hip. We're nearing the area where we actually should be. Oh, for crying. Dude, would you get the fuck out of here, man? Would you get the fuck out of here, man? Seriously. I tell you what. Alright. Oh, I hope this is coming out, because, since the last recording session, I actually lost function in one of my USB ports. So I have my microphone plugged into, like, a TARDIS USB splitter now. Like, a USB dock. And I've never used one of these before, so I don't know. It seems to be pretty... I mean, my controller is also plugged into said USB port, so... Or it said USB dock, so how bad could it be? You know? The answer is probably not that bad. Now, where is the painting for World 6? I don't actually remember. I think it's in here. Like, it's through here somewheres. Because this is that lava area, right? Yeah. How dangerous is this? For some reason, whenever I think of the HD remake of this game, like the HD re-release, yeah, this is it right here. Whenever I think of the HD re-release of this game, this is the area I think of. I've learned this spell! It's really neat! Cool, Gruntilda. Cool story. Gobi's Valley. The desert level. Wow, okay, I guess that's all Gruntilda had to say. She learned a spell and it's really neat. Well, I'm glad. I'm glad she's having fun. Alright, let's go to Gobi's Valley. Man, my ear's itching. What the hell? Ugh. I'm playing with one hand until I'm finished scratching my ear. Good leaf, man. Okay, here we go. Now we gotta go back. Through Khmia. No. Go back in through Khmia. There you go. And over here to where Gobi's Valley is. I don't think there are any faces on the walls here. No, this is all like... I don't know why they do this. But like, oh, you know what? Let's look at the galoshes. Let's not waste any golden feathers crossing that. I mean, I could just go and like just take damage. I could just take the hit, but I don't want to do that either. There's galoshes right here, so why bother? Shit, what was I talking about? What was I literally just saying? It bugs me how, like... Well, this has been pretty true of the other worlds, but... I guess it's not really that weird. How the worlds have, like, themed areas in Gruntilda's lair. Like, why does Gruntilda have a themed entrance? You'll find one more move in here, Banjo. Yeah, this is the last move, actually. Man, I'm not really familiar with this world very much. Trunker wants rain. I am shriveling up. How's your nuts bark breath? Kazooie, will eggs and feathers help? No, need water. Help. Yeah. What was I saying? Yeah. It's like, why does Gruntilda's lair have themed entrances to all the worlds? Like, was Gruntilda planning on opening her lair as an amusement park or something? That'd be pretty cool, actually. Oh, no, it's a hand! Okay. Yeah, there's a lot of crap you gotta deal with in this world. I don't think there's any way to get those except with golden feathers. Oh, you know what I didn't do? I should have gone and entered the cheat at, Treasure Trove Cove. the cheat that Cheeto gave me like 4 episodes ago. I still haven't put it in. Jeez Louise, man. Let's get some more. Hang on. Do I have full golden feathers? I do. Let's not pick up any more. Let's not get more waifus than we can hold here. Let's see. Let's actually use these golden feathers to get these notes here. Because I don't think there's any other way to get these. Because there's no transformation in this world. Ikum tokum. I'm kind of running. Oh, there's Galosh's right fucking mare. Okay, well, that was nice and stupid. No! You used up the last golden. Oh, now I can't even get out of here without using the Galosh's. Boy, I'm stupid. Holy cow. Oh, there's a Wanoop, though. There's a free man. Why are you foregoing the free man? Can I make it over here? Can I hop on this golden carpet? Nope, I can't hold up on the... I can't hop on the flying carpet. I can't get there from here. A lot of fang ha hing what oh. Oh, shit!
Only we sand eels can survive in here!
Yeah. Apparently the quicksand is really, really hot. It's like boiling sand. I can't think of any other reason why just stepping on sand would hurt you so bad. Unless it was boiling sand. Unless it was a poop pie. Oh, man. Oh, hey, there's galoshes here, too. I was just thinking, how am I going to get those notes in the sand over there? But they're so nice to always include a complimentary pair of galoshes to obtain your notes with. With which to obtain your notes. Those sentences were both correct. I just felt like being verbiose. Okay, let's just hop on here, because as you saw before, if those galoshes run out while you're on this, like, slidey sand, like, we can walk on this just fine, so that really must just be boiling sand. Big bully beat me to the boiling bottom! Well, I'm doing this all out of order. What's up here? Jack and shit. Okay, cool. Dude, fall. Okay. Oh, no. What even is that? Oh, I think there's like a target on the top of that you have to hit with a beak bomb, and that opens the pyramid. Okay, well, let's do the Shinx, because it's right here. I think this is kind of what you're supposed to do first. That would be the sensible option, I would think. There's gonna be a hand coming out of the ground any second now. I want to kick your ass, because I want health. Thank you. Man! Gory finger bits, jeez. I love how they got pictures of Banjo and Kazooie on doors that you can open with them. Wait! Aww. Thought I could make it, but I couldn't. I'ma punch you if I can move, but I can't. Anyway, let's pick up these golden feathers because I wasted every single one I had getting those notes when I could have used the perfectly good pair of galoshes. Of course, I'm wasting just about as much time picking these gold feathers up as I did using them. Okay, so if you actually climb on top of this thing, I'm not sure how much of the stuff in this world actually works, because this is the world that I, like, pay the least amount of attention to. This is the world I'm most likely to forget between playthroughs. Apart from Rusty Bucket Bay, I don't know why I forgot about Rusty Bucket Bay. When I was talking all about which worlds have transformations, I completely forgot about both this world and Rusty Bucket Bay. My nose is all fucked up. So he had to shoot eggs into his nose. I don't know how that could possibly help. Hey, that tickles. Oh, that's all you gotta do? I thought you had to shoot him into both of his noses. That cleared Jinxie's nose. Come on in. I don't have to do the other side? Will you sneeze out a Jiggy if I do the other side? That's weird that they would have two pillars here. I mean, it's like it mirrors Clanker, but you don't actually have to do it. It mirrors Clanker having the two things on either side to shoot eggs at him, but you don't actually have to do both ways. How many notes do I have? 30. Oh man, this is gonna take forever. I'm already up to 9 minutes. Of course, how much of that time was wandering around Gruntilda's lair? So in here, basically just shoot eggs at the little Pharaoh dudes. Oh, I think I missed a Jinjo. It's a Jinjo if you go the other way there. Yep. Just gotta feed the Sphinxies. The Sphinxy Jinxies. So happy. Dude. Man, aiming in this game is just so awkward. Like, how could you possibly aim? Because this controller has, like, is pretty low. Well, of course, the thing is, they would have designed it around that. They would have designed it around the difficulties of controlling a game of this era. Junk ball. Whoa!
Oh! The pain. Everything is going dark.
Is there anything of interest here? This is an Ikumbokum. Cool. Man, listening to these sounds is reminding me of A Hat in Time. That game looks really cool, but at the same time, there are a lot of issues. I've never played it. I'm sure if I played it, I would love it, but... Like, okay, first of all, the increasing tone of the item pickup noise in that game drives me crazy. Like, it's... And the way it never seems to complete a full scale. It's like, ugh. You know? And, well, I don't want to shit on it because because it's a really cool game. I just have these issues. So the other problem I have is that everything seems so cluttered. Like, it reminds me a lot of Psychonauts. The kind of the level design and the aesthetic of the levels reminds me of Psychonauts. Makes me wonder if Tim would play Psychonauts. Man, that would be awesome, wouldn't it? Holy cow. Because nobody really does LPs of Psychonauts. I mean, I'm sure it's just I'm not paying attention. But yeah, let's go open up this pyramid with a statue of Kazooie on top of it. Well, I want that golden feather, but I don't. But it's not worth it. Yeah. Okay. So now this is that hole's gonna open up, and you're gonna have a pretty short amount of time. But hey, that worked. Boy, that just about couldn't have gone any better. Wow. Are there any notes in here? Yeah, there are notes in here. There is notes in here? I don't know how plurals work. Like, am I talking about the notes, or am I talking about in here? Hello, my friend. I am Ruby. Can I be of some help? No? We're looking for treasure, pipe boy. Very good. I see some up there. It's yours, if you can get it. Yes? Yeah. That guy reminds me of Diddy Kong Racing, Taj. Look at his little worm thing. Look at that. A little, like, what is it? Like a little, I want to say pachyderm, but I think that's a rodent. It's like a little anteater slug or something. I swear it looks like something. A tapir or something. I don't know. A tapir. The toilet paper. Anyways. So just fart in this guy's bowl a couple times, and you'll make a little snakey snake come out. Come on, one more time. Oh, I think I need to be standing on top of the bowl when I do it. No, maybe not. How many times do I need to poop into this guy's bowl? I mean, seriously. The good leaf man, 5. Okay. Ah, 1,000 thanks, my friend. Istop will now help you with your quest.
Whoa,
man, how did they manage to keep you steady on that in the programming, I wonder, because it looked like I was going to fall off about 5 different times there. Well, thank you very much, Mr. Did I catch your name? As they're leaving, Banjo, like, asks Kazooie, did we get his name? I don't remember if we got his name. Anyway. Here's this area. This area always makes me think of Nintendo Capri Suns episode where he got Lucagen and I think Josh Jepson to COCOM. But then he lost his own recording. So he lost his own recording, but he still had the COCOMs. So he went through and tried to replicate his half of the conversation. It's like, what? Come on. You're crazy, man. I need to ride this carpet eventually here. There's no other way to do... What is this? Honeycomb piece? What? Oh man, how long do I have to pick that up? Oh, okay, it's just there. That's nice. Why would... If there's no time limit between hitting the button and picking it up, then why wouldn't you just have it start out in that little cactus loop before I even started, as soon as I came into the world? Seems pointless. How the hell am I walking down that? Oop. Here you got these guys. More guys to feed eggs so that they can burp. Bob. Ugh, man. Ugh. This is the first time I've recorded Banjo-Kazooie, like, since the first couple of episodes where I've actually been recording in the morning. So, as soon as I'm done this recording, I pretty much have to get all up on the old movie maker and split this shit. Skip this ship. Ugh. Man, I'm so tiny. These make me nervous, man. Making me nervous. Alright, come on. Oh, come on, one more. There you go. I really do like this world. Like, I think this world is a really fun world to play, but I'm not a huge fan of the desert aesthetic, just personally. I like how they gave it an Egyptian flavor instead of just, you know, making it the dry. I mean, you pretty much have to give it a desert. I mean, what other flavors are there? Well, I guess you could give it, like, well, there are a few other flavors. I mean, hell, I have, like, an entire game coming. Oh, no! Ow! Okay. Okay, let's jump to the... Oh, gee, is there a honeycomb? Are there any honey hives around? Because I could use some health. Because I'm down to 3, and I don't like being down to 3, and especially not in this world. I think there's a honey hive over here. Back at start. No, that's shoes. There's one. Let's bust this up from afar with eggs, because as you can see, there's bees around it, so... Those bees will actually come after us. But they don't seem to realize that I'm here. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. Okay, we're good. Oh, yeah, there's a Jinjo over here. Don't accidentally step on the exit world platform, because there's no coming... There's no recovering from that if it happens. It's over. Okay. So, we're three honeycombs richer, honey health, whatever. There's more notes up on here. Let's grab these while we're here. Just grab notes if there's one advice I can give you about playing this game, it's grab notes when you see them. You know, it's like when you're playing Donkey Kong 64. If you see bananas, that wouldn't take two. If I get some pickup, that would be nice. Seriously, do I need to take a drink of water? Ow, no! Figures, as soon as I reach over to take a drink of water, I land right in front of a bee. These guys look like... You know what they look like? They have, like, the exact same palette as the beetle enemies in Kirby Triple Deluxe that you get the beetle ability from. They have, like, literally the exact same palette. It's almost uncanny how exactly they have the same palette as that. If I didn't know better, I'd say that they based those beetle enemies in Kirby. I hate the name Kirby. Kirby Triple Deluxe. Ah. Ah. Because the way my mouth is, like, shaped, I can't say it without stuttering. It's the same thing with Super Paper Mario, except I can do that kind of, but Kirby Triple Deluxe. Like, I end up saying, like, Kirby Truple. Dude, are you fucking kidding me? Why is this fucking pillar so damn tiny? Like, seriously, I'm just trying to eat my fish, man, but he keeps falling off the fucking plate. Dude! And as if that wasn't bad enough, the area you have to jump from is, like, -2... Okay, here we go. Sheesh. Let's get a better angle on this. This is not... This is the opposite of a better angle, but okay, well, I did it. Jeez, what a pain in the ass. Oh, that's it? I thought there were 4. I'm losing my mind. Obviously. Okay, there we go. That opens up this, so let's head in.